Long ago, the Traveler came to the Sol system. It brought a golden age to humanity. They explored, they built, they thrived. Until the collapse. A terrible calamity caused by the Traveler's oldest enemy. It brought the people of Sol to the brink of extinction. When all hope seemed lost, the Traveler saved humanity by creating us. With the Traveler's light, ghosts and guardians together protected the last city from the forces of darkness, no matter the cost. But we soon learned even that was more complicated than we thought. Our enemies wielded the light, shaking our faith in what we once thought we knew. From old conflicts grew new alliances. And just as our enemies learned to wield the light, we found a way to leverage the darkness. In that darkness, we rediscovered the being responsible for humanity's collapse. The Witness. It wishes to create what it calls the final shape. Our universe, perfected in the name of salvation. Everything calcified into eternity. We've tried to follow the Witness into the Traveler, and every attempt has failed. Until now. Vanguard Scout Crow wished his way inside. The paracausal bond he shares with his twin sister will guide us safely through. Now, our leaders prepare a strike force to enter the Traveler, to confront the Witness. That's our role, the tip of the spear. Every battle we've fought has brought us to here and now. It's time. Is it possible? There you are! You don't know how long I've been looking for you.
Do you live without purpose? Anguish, bliss, a meaningless cycle of action and reaction.
The witness nears the final shape.
We're initiating Operation Ahamkara. Now.
The Traveler cannot abate it much longer. The portal is unstable.
Ikora, the Guardian, me. I won't lose another soldier in this war.
I feel the grasp of the witness. It's fighting me. This might be the end.
If it is, it was an honor to serve the last city with you.
have no signal on either Vanguard leader. The Guardian's comm line is open, but non-responsive.
Mara, we're here. We crashed, but we're here. What is this place?
The Traveler contains many more multitudes than you or I could ever comprehend. You are yet in the threshold. Whatever lies between you and the Traveler's pale heart is a side effect of the Witness's paracausal mutilations. I can feel its power stretching through the portal. I will try to buy us time. Go!
Take it. The Witness must be using them to search for us. That's a sphere of concentrated darkness. It's being detained in a resonant shell. Destroy it! Ah! The darkness unraveled, and it's projecting something. Overlay of possibilities. We have taken incoming, but I'm picking up something strange with them. A concentrated source of light. Imbued with extra light now. Let's try activating that concentration of darkness again. It worked. The light made the imagined structures solid, made them real. Scans are inconclusive. I'm getting conflicting readings on age and material composition. Guardian, I'm not sure what that creature is. It reads like a Cylon, but its genetics are scrambled, changed.
Agents of the Black Fleet. Nezarek, Rolk, even Kallus. They were just the beginning.
Thank you.
I have not been able to reach the Vanguard. Even my bond with my brother is faint.
We'll find the others. We have to. I don't think we can win this fight.
The witness is pushing back against me, trying to exert its will over everything. I will hold the portal open as long as I can. The fate of all things rests on you. Guardian, hurry. When you find my brother, tell him the Allied Coalition will protect the city in the Vanguard's stead. Tell him that we will join you as soon as we are able. Tell him that I...
He knows. Are we alive? Is this... This is... Guardian. That vision. I think we're inside the Traveler. We've crossed the threshold. This is it. We're really here. Mara? I can't pick up anything. No comm signals from Seoul. Zavala, Ikora, do you read us? Nothing. We're alone. I can feel the light here. It's everywhere. Grass? Air? It's not what I expected the heart of the Traveler would be like, but it's beautiful, isn't it? And so familiar. This is city architecture. Servants of the Witness, they must be remnants from a conquered species. I think I can channel the power coming out of that wellspring of light and dark into you, Guardian. We just need to be closer. Your power tore right through their defenses. Thank you. I know this street. I know that shop.
Thank you.
this was the old Vanguard command center, but it's changed. Light and dark are welling up here, more than I've ever felt before. It feels like you could reach out and pull all that power to you, control it. Could you? The line between light and dark is... It's gone. It's gone. Guardian, you've fused light and dark into harmony. How? We can use this. We're stronger than we've ever been. We can use this. Let's go. The transponder signal isn't far. The signal's coming from... here.
Thank you.
was intense. I need a minute. Traveler, it's hurting. I can feel. I feel it's... So, what's next? We're outmatched, we're alone, and what is that noise?
It's coming from over there.
You gotta get better boots, Crow. I could hear you coming a mile away. Now, Aldrin, he could sneak up on a fella. You're not Crow. Well, I'll be damned.
Been
a lifetime. The kid told me a few guns were on their way. Said the Vanguard would send their best. It's real good to see you two. I finally have someone to talk to about Crow's stupid haircut. Come on. I'm guessing you have questions. And I won't say I have answers. But let's talk.
I like Crow's haircut.
Where to even start?
I died.
You probably remember that. Not great. Partly my fault. Lesson learned, let's not dwell. And after that, nothing. But not a bad nothing. A peaceful nothing. I think I felt her there too. My ghost, Sundance. She was part of me. Or I was part of her.
Like we were two cards shuffled back into our deck, whole again.
And then there was... well, there was... pain. Separation. Something pulling me out. I woke up here, in this body, alone. No ghost, no way to use the light.
And what could make this traumatic experience better than finding my killer waiting for me?
But we talked it out, because we're adults.
He seems nicer these days.
Yeah, pretty low bar, I'll admit. Because we got bigger problems. Bigger, weirder problems. Crow said this was all inside the Traveler, but I already knew. It's in pain. Pain I can feel. Somebody's up in that monolith with their hand on a knife. Crow calls it the Witness. And what it's doing out here has a name too. The Final Shape. It's the end of everything. Thank you.
So I figure, might as well try to stop it.
I know I said it already,
but it is good to see you.
Just wish it were under better circumstances.
It's good to see you too, Cade. I never thought...
Hey, it's all right. I get it. This is a lot. And as much as we both want to catch up, we ain't got that kind of time yet. We gotta get out there and find Crow. I was expecting him, not you, and that ain't a good sign.
Yeah, you're right. We can save the celebrations for later. Guardian, we should... Can we talk for a minute first? Just you and me?
I'll give you two some privacy. Last I heard from the kid, he was out on patrol, called in some sort of darkness anomaly. I'll scout ahead. Catch up with me when you're ready.
So, Cade, I looked him over while you were talking. Scan says that's really him. There's a few readings I can't explain. He's made of light, like me, like the Traveler. Ghosts are guides, conduits for the light. Cade might not be able to wield his as a weapon, but if he's like me, maybe he can share the Traveler's light, like we do. I'm not sure. This is new, but look what else we've gained. I can feel it. The way the light flows through you. Freer. Harmonious with darkness. A full chromatic spectrum. I've only experienced something of this magnitude once before. When the Traveler created ghosts to raise guardians. When I was born. We're going to need everyone to save it from the Witness. Cade's got a lead on Crow and Glint. Let's start there.
Feels a bit strange being back on this side of the comms, just like the good old days. Now, last transmission I got from Crow was just before you showed up.
You said he and Glint were scouting ahead.
Right. He called in some sort of anomaly, said he'd sniff around the perimeter. Personally,
I prefer a little more direct approach.
I ever tell you about the Hunter Vanguard before me? His name is Andal Brask. He was my mentor. Great shot. Terrible gambler. Still, we had this friendly little wager about what was inside the Traveler. I told him there's nothing. So of course Andal says, well then I'm betting on everything. Everything. Lucky guess. The inside is a composite of the outside. You're gonna see some things you recognize and some things you don't. Treat it all as real. Unless it ain't. But I can guarantee you the Shadow Legion up ahead are as real as they come.
Bird from our vision. That can't be a coincidence. Let's follow it.
Kate, is that you? Clint, where's the damn kid? I've been trying to raise you both on comms for hours.
Gone. The hell do you mean, gone?
The anomaly we were investigating, it's a construct of darkness, I think. A cave mouth. It felt wrong, like it doesn't belong here. I begged him not to go inside, but you know how he is. I tried to follow, I did. That barrier, this place, the cave, it's impossible for me to push past it all.
Stay where you are. We'll find a way through.
Locks control that barrier between us and Crow.
Cade, any ideas?
Oh, I was never good at puzzles. It was always more a chorus thing.
Scions might share a connection with that dial. see any other dials in the area.
Affirmative. The Guardian will handle this.
Please hurry, Guardian. Crow has no one to raise him if he falls.
Glint, this ain't your fault.
He's my Guardian. My responsibility.
And you're his. I know you want eyes on him, but you need to stay out of sight until help gets there.
Cade, what do you make of that bird that led us to Glint?
Well, it seems pretty obvious to me. I think it's pretty obvious to you, too. The real mystery is why nobody wants to say it out loud.
I will. A traveler. It's helping us.
Mess it up, Guardian!
Thank you.
Give us the all clear.
This must be it. Glint's right. This feels cancerous. Like a blight. But it's different somehow. What is this?
Incision.
Guardian.
You were thrust into
an unending life
of certitude.
It's in my mind. Trying to tear me apart.
Let us free you from this architect of your enslavement.
No! I did it. I fought it off. Shut it out.
No matter. Our voice will suffice.
But a facsimile. A testament to loyalty. An expression of longing.
Crow. We see his heart held in talons. We hear it beat with his twin sister's skills.
Within the final shame, we offer the vision of our pride.
Of yours. Friends,
looking for him with trust,
but, like you, he chose pain.
You use the darkness to exploit Crow's memories?
And the light to give them form.
Don't you see how beautiful it all could be?
We offered to erase Prince Aldrin's stain from the Dream City. To grant Crow dominion of the Reef, the Awoken, and all the stars beyond. But he chose pain.
Only purpose can cure his heart, and he believes his capacity for pain is that purpose.
It is why he subjects himself so completely to your traveler. This belief is taught, conditioned into you. It can be unlearned.
Crow?
Quiet. Listen. I've seen these veiled statues before. You have too. It's whispering something, but I can't quite make it out.
Stop listening to it!
I told you to wait outside. This place is... I don't know what kind of effect it's going to have on you.
He's right, Glint.
I don't care. He doesn't get to make those decisions for me. We're supposed to be a team. Guardian and Ghost. That's how the Traveler made us.
I'm sorry.
Don't ever leave me behind again. Promise.
I promise.
Let's set up camp outside. Kate's not far.
Of course he isn't. Tell me you got the drop on him at least.
You and the Guardian both need better boots.
Well, maybe I'll get lucky this time.
hard to describe. It's like these pockets of darkness are physical manifestations of the witness's presence here. An infection, festering.
You said it spoke to you.
In the dark, tempting me. The witness knows what's in our hearts and minds. It promises to make it all real as part of the final shape. Listen, whatever the witness is doing to the Traveler, our ghosts can feel it too. And it's spreading. Ikora would know what to do.
Oh, don't worry, kid. We'll find her. Even if we have to blast our way through.
I don't think it's that simple.
Sometimes it can be. Let's just get our bearings again. Refocus.
Agreed.
What a relief to see Crow and Glint again. That cave we found him in, where the witness tried to possess me. A malignant place like that inside the Traveler feels blasphemous. That wasn't just darkness. It was reshaped by the witness, corrupted. No wonder it could project itself there. At least out here, the Traveler's light still protects us. As much as it can, anyway. My shell? Don't worry. It's not as bad as it looks. The witness barely left a crack. We'd take hits and we'd get back up again. Right, Guardian? Listen, the others spotted a location nearby that resembles the Io Cradle. Sounds like something that would be of interest to a warlock we know. Helm signal. Mara, we can barely hear you. I'll try to boost the connection.
Ro? Does this reach you?
She can't hear us. I'll keep trying to clean up the signal.
The portal remains unstable, and your enemy has barred the way behind you. The abominations you encountered are of the witness's making. This is but a fraction of the power it now wields. Using stolen light, it has created a new army in opposition to the one the Traveler raised. Stewards of the final shape. No matter. The Coalition convenes to devise a method of dispelling the Witness's interference. Keitel and Mesrax have promising theories. Once this desperate attempt to slow us is left broken, we will rejoin the attack. Let my voice send you now, in flight to strike down the Witness and all its followers. Go. With hope, and with vengeance.
Thank you. I came across some wreckage when I was scouting earlier. Dismissed it as another anomaly until Ghost described Ikora's ship.
No one was inside. So she's alive. We just have to find her.
Yeah, and that's always easier said than done.
I'm sending you some coordinates. You're on the lookout for something that resembles the cradle on Io. We'll start there.
We're not the only ones looking for Ikora.
The Hive already bothering you?
We can handle them.
Well, go right ahead. I'll be here for moral support.
Concentrated darkness.
The least we can do is put it to good use.
More of the Witness's abominations. Careful, Guardian.
Of that wreckage. Any sign of Ikora? Or her ghost?
Nothing yet.
Ikora abandoned her ship. Maybe she found something.
Maybe so, but going it alone isn't worth the risk. I learned that the hard way.
Luckily, she's got the three sharpest hunters in the system to back her up.
Oh, yeah. And when do they get here?
That shield creates concentrated light. You can use it to power those wells.
Where light rises, darkness recedes.
Sounds like you've been reading Ikora's field journals.
I always try to learn from the best.
More Hive ahead. Eyes up.
Zebu Arath's followers again. Of course they'd answered the Witness's call.
Well, I'm glad somebody's been paying attention. Me, I see three glowing green eyes. I open fire, and then apologize to Eris later.
Thank you.
Using both light and dark energy is what brought down that barrier.
Mara often spoke of the balance of light and dark. We awoken were made in conflict. Our connection to darkness is as ingrained as our connection to light. Not all Guardians are awoken, but it does feel like we all share that conflict.
This is definitely Ikora's ship. Let's take a closer look.
Commander, Guardian, I hope you are both safe and that you found Crow. I haven't been able to raise you on comm, so I cannot be certain. You know I am not one to be moved without evidence. How did you put it, Zavala? Scientific obstinance. But there is an uncanny sanctity to this place. I feel an impulse. I seek to commune with the Traveler myself. I sense if I reach out, that it will reach back. If not here, where? Find me. I'll be at the cradle. It's just how I remember it.
Stay sharp. I'm picking up a reading very similar to something Crow and I ran into shortly after we arrived.
What, another charming gunslinger with roguish good looks?
A hive ogre. But it definitely has your humility.
Got it on the run. Crow, how did you manage to avoid it earlier?
Avoid it? Glint, how many times did you revive me? 5? 6?
12. But who's counting?
Not bad. Can't be efficient, be persistent.
It's down. And look. Light. It's creating a path forward. Guardian, I'm sensing a surge in power. In both light and dark.
Hey, when we find Ikora, if she's...
Ikora's strong. I'm sure she's fine.
Oh, that's good. Great. But not really what I'm worried about. I was gonna ask if you think she's still mad at me?
For what?
I made a promise, then I broke it. I died.
Get ready, Guardian. The Witness's forces are heading your way.
The last of them. Let's get to Ikora. We found Ikora. She's deep in meditation.
If Ikora zenned out, she might actually get some answers from the Traveler.
Thank you, Guardian. I thought that maybe here, maybe the Traveler might give me some sort of guidance, as it once did for the Speaker. I closed my eyes and I opened my heart and mind. I think I heard it. Screaming.
So did we, when we came through the portal.
This place.
We know.
The Witness infecting the Traveler. Darkness combined with light. I wish Osiris could see it. He was always ready with a hypothesis. But here's mine. The Witness brought darkness into the Traveler. Everything you see here inside it is a physical manifestation of a thought made real by the light. Your thoughts, mine, the Witness's. It plans to weaponize that light, reshaping reality outside the Traveler into a perfect stillness. A great silence, never changing, never dying. Imagine your greatest triumph, or your most profound regret, immortalized as a part of a universe where nothing exists except by the Witness's consent. It chooses what your eternity will be, and imprisons you safely inside it. This is its promised salvation. This is the final shape. The Witness sees itself as the god it wishes the Traveler was. And although the Traveler resists the Witness's corruption, it and everything we know will eventually succumb. I always warn Zavala not to put all his faith in the Traveler, to save some for the rest of us. But maybe faith in the Traveler is exactly what we need. If light is powerful enough to destroy the universe, then light is powerful enough to destroy the Witness. Come back safe. So, is there anyone else with you? Not Commander Zavala, I assume. This isn't quite up to his standards.
Hey. I did my best, all right? Given the circumstances, I think Big Blue will forgive me. Will you?
No. It's too much. It's just
too much. It's one thing for the witness to look in our hearts and minds, to conjure up our memories, but this...
Hey, Cora, come on, look at me.
I see you.
I know this is hard. It's tough for me, too.
Tough? What do you know about tough? You are always running off to play renegade, leaving me and Zavala to shoulder all the responsibility when we were supposed to be a team.
I know. I'm gonna make it up to you.
All right.
You like me?
Don't get ahead of yourself. You still have a lot to make up.
Well then, we better get started.
Ikora has always had a strong connection to the Traveler. I think that's why she's so confident. Why she's never needed the faith Zavala has. She hasn't sought guidance like this for a long time. But this place makes you reassess what faith means to you. Ikora said our memories reshape the landscape, like the Ascendant Plane. But here it's pure. It's not a recreation, it's a reimagining. That's why the Witness is here. It wants to weaponize the Traveler and transform the universe into a fixed state based on what it believes we deserve. The Witness thinks purpose is a static idea. Its promised salvation is a perfect ending it chooses for us. That sounds more like obsession to me. You can't bottle life. You can't pin its subtleties in place. It's wild and variable, imperfect. Like the light, it shines out in all directions, shadows and all. Commander Zavala would agree. Come on, Guardian. We've got a fire team to reunite.
Scans are conclusive. Your body is a construct of light, even if you aren't able to wield it as a weapon.
Well, I guess I need my ghost to do that.
Yes, but still, this is nothing short of a miracle. A miracle that could only be made possible here, in this impossible place.
You sound like Zavala. Next you'll be saying that the Traveler brought me back for a reason.
It did.
Ikora...
Give me a better explanation, then.
I don't have one. All I got is my hand cannon. No golden gun. No ghost.
Can I ask you something deeply personal?
Shoot.
What did you see when you died your final death?
No, that ain't fair.
No, it isn't.
Light. So bright, it burned me all the way up, but I didn't feel any heat. Not a lick. I didn't feel anything, actually. Not with my body, because I left that back there. These Anatonauts might call it being one with the Traveler, but I call it home. No pain. No fear. No Vanguard paperwork. That's heaven.
And Sundance?
She was shining there, too. You want to know a secret? I miss it. Even more than I miss you.
So which one of us gets to play commander till we find Zavala?
I'd have liked to see you try, but the Guardian will take point.
House Salvation. They really believe this much in the Witness's plan?
The Witness is offering them exactly what they want. An end to suffering. That seal is pyramid technology. The Witness's forces are likely nearby.
Let's see if we can get the jump on them. Maybe they have a key.
Statue.
We've seen these before. On the moon, Europa, the Black Garden. It shouldn't be here.
Not to change the subject, but I finally got a Vanguard signal. You're welcome.
Zavala needs to be our priority. Pass the telemetry through.
Thank you.
Traveler used its light to terraform planets, to seed life, while the Witness uses it to reshape this world in its own image.
Hey, did Zavala have anything nice to say about me at my funeral? He always gave the best eulogies.
No, not a word.
Seriously?
He wasn't there. Wouldn't come out of his office.
I get it. Sometimes grief's a locked door.
Not grief. Shame.
Salvation again, right on top of us.
Go get him.